Outdoors, sound of nature, getting to go explore all the wonderful places of Nevada. These last few months have been hard on all of us, and we've had to adapt to many changes. But now that things are opening up again, Spirit of Nevada gets to do what we do best, and that's go out and find all the neat places around our state so that you all can take your friends and family to go exploring. So today we're going to go on a special adventure with our new BFF, Rob, and he's gonna take us around the beautiful Pahranagat National Wildlife Refuge, and we're gonna see all the cool things you can do in one spot.
So each refuge and the refuge system throughout the nation has got a refuge purpose. So the refuge was actually purchased for a specific purpose. Pahranagat was purchased for migratory birds. We're a oasis in the Pahranagat Valley, a major migration hub for the birds that are migrating through the Pacific flyway and these flight corridors. So this one, when the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service purchased this in 1963, they identified the importance of this area for migratory birds, especially waterfowl. So they purchased this one for waterfowl and really like it. When I first moved out here, I just wanted to get the Western experience. I'd never been out west before, wanted to work with the cinnamon teal. I fell in love with the place. The sunsets are amazing. The night skies are absolutely amazing too. And there's no light out here and you can see the little satellites go by. I mean, it's pretty amazing.
Divided into three main areas: Upper Lake, Middle Marsh, and Lower Lake. At the Upper Lake, you'll find 15 primitive lakeside campsites. It's a first come, first serve basis, and the cost is zero. If you'd like to make a contribution, you can at the registration kiosk, and it's the perfect way to end your day after hiking, hunting, or exploring. Run away. So what fun do we have in store for tonight?
So we're going to be running the airboat tonight, catching waterfowl. So the airboat running at night is a technique that we use, one of our techniques that we use to catch waterfowl. It's the drone of the engine and the lights confuse the waterfowl at night, and we're able to use a net and scoop them up. So it's going to be pretty
fun. So how many geese do we expect to catch tonight?
There's about 20 geese down there right now, so we're hoping for at least a 75%. Capture rate, but they are veterans and they know what we're getting ready to do as soon as they hear the engine fire up. They're flightless right now, so all they have is to be able to swim and try to get away from us. So we're going to use the power and the speed of the boat to come up on them. And then when they hear the boat and the noise comes real loud and they see the light, it confuses them. And then we'll be able to get up on them and start shooting them.
All right, so what's the benefit of banding these geese?
So waterfowl banding, or banding in general, is a mark recapture program that we use, and it's the best mark recapture program, in my opinion, in the science today, because it uses citizen science. recapture this data, whether it be hunter harvest, or if you see the band and able to read it, or if you find a dead bird that just died of old age or whatever, you can report this information and to the bird banding lab, which is in Maryland, and then that gives us information on mortality, survival, reproductive rates. All this information goes into one of the things that they use to be able to set up, or biologists use to be able to, in the flyway, they'll be able to use to come up with harvest estimates and come up with bag limits and seasons for hunters.
So this one here is already banded. So these are the pin feathers with the new feathers emerging. So this bird cannot fly right now, which is why we target them. We can go out and get them, otherwise they would just get up and fly away on us. So it takes a month or so for them to get new wings in, and then they can move along. But this one here is a recapture. It's got a band already when we captured it. We'll have to look at the data and see if it's one of ours from the previous years, because we've been doing this for a few years. We also frequently catch geese from Reno, but you never know what you could find.
You may call it in the sea, but you've only lost the night. Preset all your pretty feelings. May they comfort you tonight. And I'm climbing over something. And I'm running through these walls. I don't even know if I believe. I don't even know if I believe. I don't even know if I believe everything you're trying to say to me.
The Pahranagat National Wildlife Refuge is a sweet escape from Las Vegas. It's one of the most beautiful places I have been to, and I hope you all enjoyed this episode. I'm Samantha Cheon, but you can call me Sam, with Spirit of Nevada, brought to you by the Richard Harris Law Firm.